Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Boy, a great question today sent in by Julian. Now, Julian is from Australia, but he's currently working in Mexico. And he does event planning. So, you know, we have something happens for some number of minutes, and then something else happens for some number of minutes. And he set up this nice little spreadsheet here to keep track of the time for the next event. So, the time for the next event is the time for the previous event plus the duration of the previous event. And Julian says the thing that drives him crazy is that if he deletes a row, so edit, delete row, then everything changes to a reference area. He wants to know how he can build a formula that says, hey, point to the cell above me without specifically referring to that cell. So that way, if you delete something, it doesn't go away. Now, before I get to that, I first of all want to point out this time here. And I was like, well, that can't possibly be a valid time. But if we go into Control 1, Format Cells, you'll see that Julian is using a custom number format with MIN in quotes. And that way, the people who use this understand that those are minutes. Very cool. Okay, now here's my solution. I'm not going to point to those cells. I'm going to use a function called offset. Now, offset is a cool function that says, hey, we're going to start from a certain cell. And I'm going to start from the cell that I'm in. I'm going to start from cell A3. And then we're going to go some number of rows down. Well, I don't want to go any number of rows down. I want to go minus one row, in other words, one row up, and zero columns over. And then how tall of a reference do we want? Well, we want one row. And in this case, then I want two columns. Now, the offset here is going to return, in this case, two cells. So, I want to take those two cells and I want to sum them. So, I'm going to wrap that offset function in a sum, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, and there's our answer. We'll copy that down. Now, here's the big test. Let's say that we get rid of something, so the second guy cancels. When we do edit, delete, row, everything above continues to work, because what it does is it says we're going to take the item directly above us. Well, even though we deleted the old row 6, it now understands the item directly above us, minus one row in the offset is now row 5. So, it works perfectly. Thanks to Julian for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.